Hello everyone, myself Ankit Shivare, and today we are going to solve problem 4. So the circuit is given to you. So it is a differential amplifier that is given to you, right? So this is RD, RD, and this is the NMOS, and this is the current source. Okay, so differential picture we have not discussed yet in lecture series, but I think you will be comfortable. It will not be very hard for you, right? We will be solving that concept by this numerical problem, so don't worry. So this is input common mode that is given to you. Okay, and there is something called as output common mode. Okay, so what is given here is that W by L 1 by 2 is 50 by 0.5, that is W by L 1 by 2 is 100. V in common mode is given to you 1.2 volt. ISS is 0.5 milliampere. Okay, now they have asked you what is the maximum allowable output voltage swing if V in common mode is 1.2 volt. So input common mode they have given, that is what actually happens, like when you are supplying anything to any circuit or module, you are giving some input common mode voltage and you have a wiggle in that input common mode voltage, and you in the output again you will have an output common mode voltage and you will have a wiggle there. Okay, what do you mean wiggle is, like this is the DC operating point you will set up and you will have a AC audio amplitude, suppose. Okay, so suppose you are giving 1 millivolt here, so what you are expecting here is you get at least 50 millivolt swing. Okay, so it is 50 times it is getting amplified, right? But that 1 millivolt, it will not be able to bias this circuit, right? So it needs some DC value, 1 volt, plus 0.1 millivolt swing that will be there, okay? Now, if suppose input common mode is given to you, 1.2 volt, they have asked what is the maximum allowable output voltage swing. So one thing, remember that for amplification, always, always, we try to put all the amplifiers in the saturation condition. Okay, these two transistors can go to sub-threshold, but this transistor has to be in saturation. Now question arises, why? Because this is acting like a current source. For current source property, we should have saturation condition. Okay, otherwise it will not be pulling that much amount of current, right? If suppose this goes to linear, then obviously this will be not acting like a current source. For intuitive purpose, we have given directly current source, but in actual circuit this will be replaced by a MOS. Okay, so moving forward, so what is the, if suppose this is the ISS current, you have set up the DC operating point. Okay, so this will be flowing IS by 2, this part will also be flowing IS by 2. Okay, now if suppose you change, this is V input common mode, this is V input common mode, so this is the IS by 2, IS by 2. Now you have the wiggle here. Okay, means it, this is the AC amplitude that will come here, the opposite phase AC amplitude will be coming here, that is in the input side. Okay, so one input side we are giving some AC perturbation, one input side we will give some AC perturbation, so and here it will be just the opposite. Okay, so remember this thing. So if this is the case, so what will happen, that in one end it may happen for the maximum swing that all the current will be going from this end ISS and this current will be zero. So what will be the maximum phi out you can get here is VDD, right? Because if suppose no drop is there across this RD, so this entire supply will be coming here, right? So this is the VDD that you will get, okay, in the maximum side. Okay, what is the minimum you can get here is, that is what, this entire ISS drop will be here, right? So ISS into RD. Okay, so VDD minus ISS into RD when you do, so that is the drop you will get here. Okay, but we have been asked minimum value, so this is the input common mode, right? So saturation condition, what is the condition for saturation for a MOS transistor? So if this is a MOS transistor, this is your gate, this is your drain, right? So this gate can go above this drain potential by how much amount? By threshold voltage amount. If suppose this gate potential is greater than the threshold amount, this transistor will not be in saturation. Okay, so remember this thing. Similarly for PMOS you can do it. This gate can go below the drain potential by how much amount? By threshold voltage amount. So remember this thing, this is the very intuitive part. Okay, so again you will see what is the minimum it can go, V out one can, how much it can go. It can go by this input common mode, input common mode minus some threshold. Okay, so this V gate can be higher than drain potential only by threshold amount. So 1.2 minus 0.7 you can do, that is 0.5 volt. Okay, so when you're talking about the swing, so look, if suppose entire current is going from this end ISS and this is the zero current, that is VDD, so this V out one, since we don't know RD, okay, So we cannot calculate VSD minus IS by 2 into IS is into RD, right? So how we can calculate is this potential has to go to 0.5 volt. Okay, so the swing will be what? The swing will be 3 minus 0.5, 2.5 volt. Now people will be asking that, sir, this is ISS current is going here, ISS. So we should calculate like this way, that VDD minus the, there is a maximum value you can get, and the minimum you can get is VDD minus ISS into RD. So the swing is what? Swing is ISS into RD. Yeah, I agree, but we don't know RD, right? RD is not given. ISS is given, so you will not be able to calculate by this problem. Okay, if RD was given, then the maximum swing is simple ISS into RD. As simple as that. You don't have to worry about it. Okay, so how we have used this gate potential, that this gate potential can be greater than the drain potential by threshold amount. That's it. Simple. Okay. The second part of the question is, what is the voltage gain under this condition? Now, for voltage gain calculation, we know AV is what? GVM into RD. So we don't know RD, so we have to calculate RD, right? And GM is what? GM is the transconductance. So they have three formulas, right? Under root 2 beta ID, 2 ID by V overdrive. Overdrive is what? VGS minus VTH. And beta into V overdrive. Okay. So since we know W by L ratio, we know the current. Okay. That is ID. So ISS by 2 current will be flowing from here. ISS by 2 will be flowing here from here. So ID is what? ISS by 2. So you can calculate simple GM. That is 2.59 milli. Okay. So when you calculate, you put 2 into mu is given to you 1.34 milliampere per volt square. For all the calculations you will do, you will have the same mu and Cx. WL is given to you 100, right? So you can simple put it here and you will get is 2.59 milli. Okay. So now you have GM is calculated. Now you need to calculate RD. So how can you calculate RD? So here we have solved earlier only that the swing is what? SS into RD, right? And the swing that you are getting here is what? 2.5 volt. That is the maximum you can get, right? Because if suppose this end is 3 volt, this can get 0.5 volt. So 3 minus 0.5, that is the swing, right? 2.5 volt. So simple, we can calculate by this way. So 2.5 volt is the swing, that is ISS by ISS into RD, 0.5 milliampere into RD. So this comes out to be RD is 5 kilo ohm. Okay, I think this is very easy for you, right? So I was trying to explain here also that virtual ground is here. So this is V in AC increasing. So here AC will decrease. So ISS by 2 plus delta current will be flowing from here. ISS by 2 minus delta current will be flowing from here. That is how the AC picture looks like, right? So I have explained clearly, I think. So since you know RD now 5 kilo, so you just have to substitute here 2.59 milli into 5 kilo, you will get AV is 13. So AV is minus 13, answer. So why is it is minus? Because you can look like this is the positive end we consider here, right? And this is the negative end. And these input and output, so this is the V out 1 and this is V out 2. So input and output are 180 degree out of phase. Okay, so if input is increasing here, you can see that it is output is decreasing here, right? So they are opposite in phase. Okay, so you can think like this way, there's V out 1 minus what? VDD minus ISS into RD. So one minus term is coming, right? So VDD, suppose this is the DC operating point, you can remove. Okay, DC point, it is, you can remove, it is DC voltage minus ISS into RD, that is the swing you are getting, right? So you can see that this is what you are getting, ISS into RD, right? Okay, so if suppose this is increasing, so definitely the current will be here will be more, right? So you will get VDD minus ISS into RD, minus VDD actually you should do, you get swing is minus RS into RD. This should be like this. Okay, you will get that negative symbol. Okay, so these are 180 degree out of phase. So remember this thing. I think we will solve further problems in the next section.